Population is a very important part in our economics. Population is a very simple word. Population are of many types, where the simple definition for the population is the area or the 1000 per square meter, and the people, if they are more than the particular area, that creates a population. India in today is at number one compared to China. China now stands on the second rank. India is today in billions if we talk about the word populations. Now, how is population affecting the economy of our country? Well, very much. Let me tell you one thing. Economic development is definitely going hand to hand with populations also. Now, population has created a big stir in our economy. We are developing so fast, so rapidly. Today, each and every corner has a developed area in our country. Still, we are considered as a developing nation and not the developed country. The reason is populations. The cities are overfilled with the people in our country, because there is a work opportunity given more in the cities and urbanization is taking place. Too many things are developing in our nation. But still we are considered as a developing nation. The reason is only the overpopulations. Government is trying the level best to control it. There are many reasons or many ads or many population concerned pamphlets or many things has been done by the government, like giving hum do hamare do kind of concept, and family planning, how to control the population, how to do a family planning things. Everything government is explaining, and that is also a one part which gives a development to our nation. We know that today each and everything is so much developed and so costly that it's very difficult to meet the two ends. For example, like, it's very compulsory for every human being to have 2100 calories per day as their diet. But we are developing nation, and there are many people below the poverty line, which has created a biggest stir saying that our nation is still underdeveloped. The reasons: there is no proper work opportunity, illiteracy. And why is this population increasing in the country like India? There are many, many reasons. First and foremost, the reason could be a male child. In India, there are many culture, customs, and all other religion things which says the male child is the home taker, or we can say a very important part of any family, because all the rituals will be taken care by the male child, and the female child is not given that much permission in our country. Male child, and that's the reason they just go on having a kids until unless they get a male child. So the male child problem, or we can say we are staying in a male dominating society, it's very important been given to the male child. That's the reason many females has been killed at an infant age itself. But now the scenario is changing, now the things are changing, the development is changing, and the most important thing, the point of view or looking towards the problem is changing in our country. Population, as per as 2001 census says, it was 25.8%. That was the birth rate in 2001, whereas the death rate in 2001, the census says it was 8.5. Now, why there is a difference between the birth rate and the death rate? Talking about the word birth rate, male dominating society is there, we all are aware of. The over year, males have been given more preference, females have been born, they have been killed at a very small age and everything. Still, these things are going in our place. There are many reasons why there is too much of high birth. First could be the reason is the child marriage, or we can say an early marriage. Illiteracy is a second point in that. Third, no family planning. So we need to educate our people at this point of time, saying that what is important and what not. There are many things which government is taking measures in this, and that's the reason the places like in small villages like Anganwadi or you can say a Fulwadi, where they can sit, they make the women educate that it's very important to have one or two kids only. Let it be a female or let it be a male child, but we have to change the people's perspective as far as the male child and the female child is concerned. There is a many reasons why we have definitely improved ourselves scientifically, or we can say on a medical terms. On medically, we are completely advanced country. There are many people who come down to India for the medical needs. Reason, we are cheaper. Second, we do our work very faithfully as far as the nurses, or we can say the doctors working in our country. That's definitely a good point. But over here, we are not considering that one good point over here. Our focus is on population. Now, death rate has gone down. Reason. Now, we are medically definitely at a very good position. So, even the disease like cancer can be cured in our country. Definitely not 100% curable is there for the cancer, but still we have made it a point for the person who can, maybe he is supposed to die in 5 years, but being there is a chemotherapy or all medical needs has been fulfilled, he will be able to live next 5-4 years or more. So that has definitely given a boost to this kind of things. So this was a one thing why the population is increasing, and that one thing was the birth rate and the death rate. Now, the second over here is the qualitative population and the quantitative population. Now, let's begin with the qualitative. The word itself indicates us that qualitative means a person who is quality, or we can say a skillful person who is definitely doing a work at a very qualitative part. Now, qualitative means we can say that the area is only of 1,000 square kilometers, and there are only a small group of people staying at that point of time. So we can say that the area over there is qualitative populated. Reason, if we are qualitative populated, the natural resources will be equally distributed and there will be no scarcity for such kind of reasons. On a quantitative part, more number of people are there on a very small land, and that creates a more problems. We do not have proper place to live, we do not have proper place to do a certain stuff. Occupationally also we do suffer a lot, like we are suffering right now, like deforestation and something, just because the reason is population. Over here, what happens, the natural resources are consumed more, and because of it, the natural resources is been scarcity is been there, and that reason creates more. See, the things are so much interlinked. If there is too much of populations, definitely the natural resources have been taken more, and that gives a scarcity to the other population, and that increases the price of all the goods in that particular area. Now, this is how the things are interlinked, and this is how we can say the inflation increases in the country which has more number of populations. There are many reasons. There are different kind of people. We can say a people who are productive people, and we can say the people who are not productive people. Now, let it be clear about this one word, productive. We know that the age of a child from 1 to the 15 years, he is definitely not earning anything, correct? Now, over here, the child starts earning from the age of 21 actually. As per a child labor law, a child is not supposed to work till he is age of 18. This is what our child labor says. And yes, if the child is been found working below the age of 18, it's a crime, and I think we all are aware what could be happened if you are caught doing all that stuff. So my question over here is that if the child is starting earning at the age of 18, he starts earning at the age of 18 and he is earning till the age of 60, which is definitely a 65, which is given as a retirement age of any person. So till that, they are known as the productive people, the people who have started working at the age of 18 and working till the age of 65 is known as a productive people. Reason, they are working, they are earning, they are helping out in our economy, and they are definitely giving a boost to our economic development in any developing or developed nation. Correct? Now, the people who are there after 65 to, let's say, till 80, they are definitely not working because they are retired. Now, the group of people who are from age 1 to 18 and group of people who are from age 65 to 80, they both are non-productive age. Reason, they are not working. In fact, they are the burdenized people on the productive group. We have to understand one point, the productive group is less compared to the unproductive group. And that creates more problem, or we can say a more influence in our economic development. Now the nation who is completely developed, let's say America is a developed nation, for example, Japan is a developed nation. Now over here they have the resources which is fulfilling their needs, so they are considered as a developed nation. Whereas the country like India, China, they are still underdeveloping. India can be considered as a developed nation today because we are having everything what we want, but still we are considered as a developing nation. The reason is population, corruption and inflation. Now, these are the main reasons which creates more problem as far as population is concerned. Now, population goes on increasing if we do not give them a proper education. There was a thing what government says, hum do, hamare do kind of situations. Now, the generation is changing. Thinking is changing because the people are getting educating themselves. They are so much educated, they do understand the problems. Look, there are many ads in the TVs we normally see. You know, there's one ad saying that I'm going to open a cycle shop in future. So father asks, why a cycle shop? That is definitely not a status symbol. He said, but father, what am I supposed to do if there are no fuels going to be available and people are not going to use any cars? It's only going to be the cycle which is going to be in demand. Now that very simple point make us to understand that, see, like fuel, there will be a scarcity of everything in our country if today we do not control our population. See, anything to have its effect takes some time. For this also, if we want a population to be at a sustainable thing, we have to start working today itself. We cannot be waiting for tomorrow ki chalo aaj nahi kal kar lenge aur aaj is saal nahi next saal. No, you cannot do that. You have to start working on this population problem today itself. There was a time when people used to have 4, 4, 5, 5 kids at that point of time. Because that was a custom, there was a tradition, this was, you know, there are many reasons in India to celebrate that. But we are facing that problem more. Like in the year 1961 to 1970-75, the population has increased tremendously. Like that was considered as the highest year or census so far, where the population was too much. Again, we see the difference in the population has decreased from 75 to 2000, where we see a population has decreased a bit. Well, not much, but a comparatively better than what it was in 61 and still to 75. So again, now the things in 21st century, if I talk in our words, it has been said, hum do hamare ek. People have already started working on it. So I think by next 15 to 20 years, we will definitely see a good progressive economic development because we are reducing our population. Okay, we have excellent number of manpower, but my question lies over here, are the all manpower, are the skilled laborers to work over here? No. We all are not skilled. Definitely, some or the other, everybody is skilled in some or the other region. But my question is, Is it so that where the skilled workers are more required, are we skilled enough to do so? Like child labor, the problem was there too much in 90s. Like many kids were used to make the firecrackers, or you can say a BD making, or we can say a matchstick making. Reason, they have a very fine motor development in their fingers, and it's really good because their fingers are so small that that particular chemical to be get filled up in that cracker, it's easier for a kid. Reason, they have a slim fingers, they have a very small and a fine motor development has taken place. So definitely a major child cannot do that. So kids have been used for that, which we have tried our level best to stop it. And that's what it should have been done. And that is what we are doing it right now. So the population, again, it's a major problem in our country. And that is definitely not helping us out to have a proper development in our nation. Midday meals has been started in many schools, in the municipality schools and everything. Reason, to try to educate our country as much as we can, because that gives a more developing nation and a faster developing economic growth in our country. And this is how we do a population which has created more problems. Population has created many major factors of productions. Now, a very important part of any economic development of any country depends on this particular word named as the factors of productions. Now, what are these factors of productions? Now, let's see that if I want to have a nice burger, wow, I'm tempted right now, okay? Okay, now, I want to have a nice burger. Now, for that particular burger, I have to have a bread, or you can say some vegetables, or we can say salads and some kind of cheese in it. But my question is, how am I going to get all these things? Who is going to give me, and how is this possible? Now, very basic thing, what we need in all this particular thing, what I do, I'll go to the shop, I'll purchase a bread or some salads, some cheese, and I'll prepare a burger and I'll have it. Simple, right? Well, this does look simple. But when we go in the interior of this particular process, we come to know that there are many things that is affected, or we can say they are interrelated for the factors of productions. Technically, or we can say an economical term, factors of productions are normally that things from where the original raw material is been consumed, or we can say is been produced at a larger scale. Now, over here, the factor of production, or we can say an agent for the factors of productions, are four main things: land, labor, organizations, and the capital. A very important thing. Correct? Now, we will see all these four particular things in a detailed manner. Now, let's take the first one, which is land. Now, land. Talking about the word land, it's very simple. If I ask a very simple question, what do you understand by the word land? People will be saying, land is land where we stay, we walk, we do this and that. But have ever been we considered that it's not easy for the problems, or we can say for the things like land, it's a difficult thing to do something. We cultivate, we do constructions on the land, we have forest on this thing. Everything what we do, it's on the land. Now, land, it has its own features and its own factors. And they all are divided into eight parts. The first one is the free gift of nature. Land is definitely a free gift to a human being. Is that so that I and me, you go and make a land? No. It is free gift given by the nature. The second thing in the land, it is not movable at all. We cannot move that piece of a land from here to there. So it's not mobilized enough. So the first point over here is the gift from nature. It's a free gift from nature, of course. We do not have to work hard to create a land or something. But over here, nature has already gifted us with such a beautiful thing named land. Many things can be done on the land. So it's a free gift from the nature. The second point, immobility. over here we cannot move the land, or we cannot say we can move this one piece. Okay, you know what, I'm not comfortable working over in this surrounding, I'll take my land and I'll go to some other. Impractical enough. So land is definitely not in Mumbai. You may be staying in any part of the corner of this world, but if you have the land in India, it's going to stay in India in that particular area itself. So it's definitely not in Mumbai. Third, no social cost. It does not have any other social cost. Normally, land do not expect any further things to be get maintained until and unless it's the agricultural land. Definitely, we have to maintain the fertility in the land itself. But after some times, we see that even overuse of that land has created the land go barren. Means we cannot grow anything in that. Now, how to bring that fertility back? Maybe there are certain chemicals, like example urea or something, can be used, or we can say we can change the crop, like 6 months for jowar or 6 months for rice or something. This can help to retain the particular fertility in our land. This could be one reason. The next point over here is the diminishing returns. Now, diminishing return over here exactly means, see, when we can use one land for multi-purposes. For example, I can cultivate the things on that, either I can build something on it, I can build an industry on it, I can build a house on it. So, things are on multi-purpose. So, land is a kind of an investment which never ever tries to, you know, give you a loss business in that. That's why in India it has been said, land is considered as a gold. You know, it never gets old. So it's like gold is gold. So over here, the land is a kind of a gold which gives you in return more than what you have spent already on it. Alright, it gives a fixed supply. This is the next point. Fixed supply means I know that I have only 100 square kilometer land or something. I'm going to get only that much of production done on it, or only that much of area. There is fixed thing in it. You cannot increase the growth on it. So this is how the fixed thing is depending on the land itself over here. So this was the next point, which means a fixed supply. The next point over here, or the next point we can say, is the passive. It's a passive act. Land itself cannot grow itself, right? Land cannot grow anything on itself until and unless there is a labor being given to it. Like if I want to grow a wheat, there has to be a farmer who is supposed to work on that land. So land is a passive part in entire factors of productions. But a very important, of course. So land over here is there, but a labor is required to do certain work. So land over here is a passive one. Next one is the land is permanent. Land cannot be changing its position or its size or anything by itself until and unless you make them to do so. So land is a permanent. The next point over here is the big 8 points. The first one is the free gift from the nature. Second one is the supply is limited. Next, it's immobility. Third, no social cost is required. It is a passive one in to do so. Fixed supply differs in fertility. So all this point is making a land a very important part for the factors of productions. Now the second one is the features of labors.